All right, so today I'm going to go over how to make a water filtration device. I've made a what they call a stack bucket one. Today I'm just going to be doing one for my chicken water. I have a auto water set up outside, which we'll look at in a little bit. Don't need a whole lot of stuff. Don't need ceramic filter. You can get on Amazon. I think I bought a two-pack for 26 bucks. This is just a lid to the bucket I'm going to be using. Or not bucket, but it's a 33-gallon drum. I'm going to be using a 3.5-gallon bucket as the top for this. You can, like I said, you can do these with a double bucket system, so you can filter water. These ceramics will remove all the dirt and stuff. I'm not really worried about chemicals. You just have to look. This one's actually made for an actual water purifier. The one that's in my double stack bucket system was I got it from, I think, Cheaper Than Dirt several years ago. I like that one because it actually came with a sock that goes over this. That'll stop a lot of the big stuff from going into it. This one did not. So what I'm going to have to do on the bucket is probably put a piece of t-shirt or something, because this is actually right on the edge of the woods. So it gets a lot of tree bark and other stuff, dirt and stuff in here. So I'm going to try to put something to kind of stop it from clogging my filter. Then what you do is I take these filters off once or twice a year, soak them in a little bit of bleach, scrub them out, and then put them back in, run water a couple of cycles through them, and then go from there. A lot of these are ceramic with a charcoal center. This one I'm not 100%. I wouldn't go spend a lot of money because it's just for the chicken water. You can just feed them, water that's got particles in it. Not a real big deal. They drink out of mud puddles, but it clogs my system up. I've had a problem with it clogging my water nibblers up, and I'll show you those too when we go outside. So first thing I'm going to need is, this is a 13/32 bit drill. Like I said, bucket. If you want to do a two bucket, you need two buckets, one with a lid. So, and what you'll do is just pretend this is the lid to the bucket. This is going to be your bottom bucket lid. Real simple. You're going to drill a hole in your lid. And hole in the bottom of your bucket, which I'll have to go to the back side. Actually, I usually go through the back side, but it's got the plastic. All right, let me get a razor to cut this tip off here. It's got a little tip right here that I won't be able to drill. It's going to be off center, and I'll be right back with you. So I got that done. So let's go ahead and drill a hole in the bottom of this. Burrs and everything plastic out of here. Sure that both sides are clean. Burrs on both things here. Take a razor blade or whatever you got. And a pocket knife here. Just clean it out. We'll see how this one works, because this one's actually got a little bit of a dome on it. We'll see how that bucket sits. I don't know if it's going to press down on it or not. Hopefully it does. Alright, so once we get that done, it's going to come with wing nut. See here, it's a wing nut. Some of them come with two washers, I believe. This one only has one. I leave the washer on. I only drill this hole big enough for the tip to go through, then I kind of screw it through. We're hoping that it's the right size. Might have to go up a drill bit. Yep, we'll have to go up one size. We don't want to make it too big. I'd rather make it small and work my way up than, because this one doesn't give you the size. Drill bit. The other one did, but I don't remember what it was. That's several years. Give me 1 second. I got the size now. Unfortunately, this doesn't have the size on it. Just like I told you, what I started with was a And some of these do have different size screws on here. Like I said, this one's actually made for like a water purifier you put up in your kitchen. So just kind of work your way from whatever, you know, you'd rather drill small than too big. But, I'm gonna drill the bucket first and check it before I drill a hole in the lid to the drum, because I only have one of those. I got plenty of buckets. All right, let's try this. Didn't take much off. Let's see what we got now. Clean the bucket. All right, let's see how she did it there. Can go a little bit bigger than this because it has that rubber washer that's a good size on there. Definitely don't want to go bigger than the washer, and then we'll be screwed. We'll have to start over. Like I said, bucket's cheap, drum lid not. Let's try this. Go up another size. We're gonna wall it around a little bit. I think that's what I had to do to that one. That one doesn't leak. Not too much, a little bit at a time, work your way. There we go. Alright, so that fit right in there. Like I said, leave the washer on. Washer's good size. As long as we're covering the washer up, we're good. Washer's actually pretty tight on there. Run it through. Alright, so we got that part done. Now, let's drill a hole in the lid. Take our time with it. Take it out, check it. Nope, a little bit more. We also got some burrs on it. All that crap off. All right, take your time, no rush. Actually tighter than the bucket, so we're good. Alright, so washer back on. Actually, let's clean the burrs off. Be careful, these ceramic filters, you drop them, they're gonna shatter. Well, you get a good seal, especially with a washer gonna seal. It's probably the most important. Alright. Really worried in the inside, but at the same time we want the wing nut to seat properly. Washer on, through the bucket. Question is it long enough? Here's... We got some threads through. Washer on. Question is, do we have enough threads through? To grab it. Let's see if we stick it on back upside down. And I actually had to stick the wash or the wing nut on upside down. Too tight. It's the only thing about plastic. And there we go. So we'll mount that on top. Water will fill up in here and then it'll drain down. It's a slow drain process, but a 5 gallon bucket takes about a day. If you're doing these for the two bucket system, you can get you a seal lid. Let's see if I got one. So you can get something like this. These actually have a rubber seal inside. This one does too, but it's going on something different. But anyway, this one will go on the top bucket. You can drill a hole and put you a air valve for like a tire. Get the right size, cut it, pop it through. You can actually pressurize it. It'll actually filter a little bit quicker. I did it once, but I drilled the hole too big. For the size air valve I got, I wasn't really worried about it because it just sits in here, and I use that double bucket system for my plants when I do the hydroponics in the microgreens. But like I said, these are running about $5 or $6. I actually got lucky and got some buckets from a local Chinese place. They food grade buckets, so you may not even have to pay for it. I paid I think $16 or $17 for the 33 gallon barrel. I just went and picked up some more barrels. They're a little bit pricey right now, especially with everything going on. But we want to make sure all of our animals' water's covered. I've got a 275-gallon tank out there also. I'm not 100% if it's food grade though. I believe it was. I'll have to look at the labeling on it. I got it from a friend. But the barrels I got now had flavoring for candy and stuff in it, so those are pretty good barrels, and I know they're food grade because it says right on them. Just be careful where you get your barrels. Make sure they're labeled. If they're not, you need to make sure they're a source that you trust. You don't need to be feeding your animals chemicals and then you end up losing your flock, especially right now with everything going on. So we're gonna take this out here. We're gonna stick it on there. I've got a lock ring that locks this on here. It's sealed, and we're gonna see how this does. And it's supposed to rain tonight, and I think into tomorrow. So hopefully we'll get it that barrel filled up. We're gonna step outside and take a look at.
All right,
the,
so here
setup.
We are.
It goes on, and then we're gonna take this lock ring. Don't really have to have the lock ring, but all these animals around here, and I don't want it to bucket to fill up, especially for 5 gallon and tip off. This thing's actually sitting up on bricks. Of course, water has to be above your water. All right, lock that down. Now, sometimes you may have to stick small air hole in this lid. I'm not sure if it's gonna work. If you don't, you will. I'm sorry about that. They all got something to say. Turkeys, chickens, all of them, ducks. But if you don't, you're gonna lock it up. You're gonna vacuum lock this system up. The water won't roll when this is completely sealed. It won't flow. It'll flow for a little bit and then it'll build a vacuum up and no water will come out. So you may have to drill just a small hole. Yeah, see, exactly what he said. So that you don't do that. I've seen people use these water nibblers, and I had one guy say he lost all of his rabbits. Same thing. I had the same setup all over on the rabbit system. You have to put a small hole. I had actually had 2 liters. Drill a small hole in the top. Never happened. It happened several times when I didn't drill the hole in it, and I realized what it was doing. Small hole, so it won't lock like that. Because like I said, you'll end up killing your animals. But so you can see, well, you may not be able to see, but up here there's a rip in my roof, and I notice a lot of water comes down from that, so that's why I put this where it's at. You can put a gutter system on your chicken coop or something. You ain't got to have it on both sides. Just put it on one side, block off, and put you a little downspout or whatever. So we're going to try this and see how she works. And I'm going to show you here the second this system set up. Let me get this off of here. Sorry about that. All right, so all I have is a standard water spigot. And I've got a PVC piece that screws onto it, holds it, and then I siliconed it just to make sure. And then this is just a sink hose. I had to use an adapter so that it would connect to my, because it's a female to female, or female to male, or whatever I had here. It just wasn't the right size. I couldn't screw it on because it's two different sizes. Just kind of see what you can get because there's several sizes of this. Same thing here, screws into my PVC pipe. And let's go in here. Try not to make y'all dizzy. Oh, look, we got a friend. All right. Let's see what we got here. So here's the water nibblers. These little bowls. You can get these at Tractor Supply. I bought these online because it comes with the tees. Real easy system to make. I actually had it freeze on me. I connected it for the winter, or disconnected it. Connected it too soon. We got another freeze. These are really nice though, because they fill up, and every time they drink and hit that, fills up full of water. You can always stick you a little bowl over here to get your chickens to learn how to use it. Looks like we got one I gotta replace. This one here, you gotta watch them. See how full that is? That should not be that full. Let's turn that and let's check it. And it looks like it might be filling up slowly. So I'm gonna probably replace that one. You gotta watch these things. But like I said, if you get dirt in the system, it'll block these things up. I think that one is leaking. I can always do this, too. If you over-tighten them, nope, it's going to leak from there. Tighten it. See, I can leave it just like that. They still got plenty of water nibblers here, and I can change that out later, maybe. Is it still dripping? It might be. All right, so we may just have to leave it like that. I did, these come with little rubber washers, but I just wrapped them in Teflon tape. To me, that was a little bit better. But yeah, you get like a pack of 25 really cheap, whereas you pay like $5 or $6 for two at Tractor Supply. So that's pretty much the system. Like I said, and I'm hoping this works, I'm gonna put a little cotton shirt or something on top of here. So it doesn't, all this big stuff, you can see all this trash up here. Piling whatever is going to go straight into that bucket and clog up my filter. You're still going to get clogged over time. See here, water will start clogging. It'll start clogging up that ceramic filter. But anyway, that's pretty much it. I can go over how to build the water if you would like. Just comment, let me know. But that's pretty much it as far as that system goes. But if you got any questions, just put them down in the comments. And thanks for watching.